8 March 2018, tensions are high at a public participation process held at Montevideo Primary School in Montana. Fewer than 100 nearby residents were told about a proposed multi-million rand mega development right on their doorstep. Consulting group planning partners and associates paved out the future of the now closed King David Golf Course, located next to Cape Town International Airport. Community members heard that the land has been reclassified under special open space and that the entire 18-hole golf course had already been rezoned by the city to make way for 350,000 square meters of industrial and commercial property. Planning partners Jeff Underwood explains.
The trustees for the golf club said we can't have a golf course anymore. We're going to join up. They joined up with Mowbray, and it's now King David Mowbray. And so what they did is they put together a package which they then put out to the market, their other developers, to say, this is our land. They did a basic environmental scan and a very basic town planning overview. And then they put it out to the market and said, any developer who is interested in buying the land or entering into a long lease, make us an offer. And so there were a number of developers that made them offers, and they selected the best offer, which came from Atterbury. Atterbury, being a development company, has entered into, subject to rights and that sort of thing, a 99-year lease on the land.
It's referred to by the golfing fraternity as the best-kept secret that provides the perfect escape from the bustling city life. Reports say Jewish representatives purchased the massive area of Cape Flats farmlands during the 1950s with the aim of creating a modern-day sports club offering a range of sporting activities such as golf, tennis, bowls, and more. Because this purchase happened during apartheid, black residents who make up the majority of the area had little to no say in the use of the land. That continues to this day. A security firm is now stationed at the golf course with more than 10 German Shepherd guard dogs on standby. Residents claim the privately owned land and proposed development aims to benefit minority interests instead of the community. The town planners, however, said this development would lead to jobs, but no mention was made of the type of jobs or hiring process. Planning partners Tim Florence.
What is this development going to bring to your community? The answer is jobs. It's going to bring jobs. There's 350,000 square meters of industrial land going on. That's a lot of development. Jobs this community, as you said, doesn't have at this point.
Collectively, residents of Montana, Montevideo, and Charlesville make up the Durrheim region. No official from the city of Cape Town nor local ward councillor was present at the meeting.
Knock-on effect of development. Say what you want about it, but it produces rates for the city. Rates equals further development. It equals more housing for people. It equals better transport. Whether or not the city uses that money for those purposes is not our problem, actually.
While a few community members welcomed the proposed development, others felt the public participation meet was an attempt at rubber stamping a planning procedure that received the go-ahead without their input. Some residents staged a walkout as a sign of disapproval. Noise and air pollution, as well as a dramatic increase in peak hour traffic, were some of the issues briefly discussed. School principal and chairman of the Durrheim Ratepayers Association, Terence Timmett, offered his input.
We wouldn't like our community to be disturbed by greater volumes of traffic. Secondly, we wouldn't like to see that the ecology of an area which had been coming along for such a long time is disturbed. We would like to see that whatever development takes place takes into consideration the residents of the area, and that whoever develops takes cognizance of the fact that it has to be inclusive in whatever they do.
The plush open space represents a green basket within one of the city's most densely populated areas, where the legacies of apartheid's Group Areas Act are severely felt. Residents argued that the land would be better suited for projects aimed at improving the dire condition of the area at large. They said centers for skills development, a community hall, urban park, or housing are more pressing. Durrheim community members shared their opinion on the proposed development.
For many years, we've been struggling to get sport facilities in our area. For indoor facilities, for libraries, like a 5-in-1 type of facility for the three areas here. I mean, we've been asked, why can't you do it on the field next to ShopRite? No, nothing.
All of this is going to translate into rands and cents, and it's going to translate into job opportunities. Whether we actually get the jobs in this area or not remains to be seen.
We must understand and say, what will be the best for us? So if it's going to increase our challenges now, make them worse, it's not acceptable. But if it is going to alleviate them, then I think it's much better.
It's only going to benefit industry. It's not going to benefit the community. So for me, I won't give it approval, because at the end of the day, it's of no benefit really to us.
While the meeting took place, just 500 meters down the road, Krisani Drive in Guguletu remained on high alert as community members were demonstrating around the issue of land. Meanwhile, South Africa waits to see how newly elected President Cyril Ramaphosa will implement the ANC's plan of redistribution of land without compensation. At the same time, the Democratic Alliance says land should remain in the hands of private owners and not the government, as proposed in Parliament by the economic freedom fighters. Debates such as these place the proposed development of King David Golf Course on par with national discourse around questions of land. Residents were told they had just over 2 weeks to voice any comments or concerns to the city in writing. The proposed development also suggested closing one end of Bolotti Road to divert traffic through the new industrial area, then onto Robert Sobukwe Drive. A second public participation meeting is scheduled to discuss this within the coming weeks. Benedict Partha, reporting for Cape Metro News, Montana, Cape Town.